Neoflame here, coming right at you with another episode of DayZ Standalone, a special edition today. We are taking a long trip to find the best military loot in the entire game right now. And I have spent some time in the game so far, so I've been running around the map and I've been looking for the best loot ever. So I've been running around and I noticed some good loot spots on the entire map. That is right now above Kamenka, a military base featuring 4 barracks and 1 hospital and 1 big residential loot building. So yeah, we are right now in the Kamenka military base above Kamenka. If you just run up north like I showed in the little animation, you will find this little base, and it has 4 barracks. Keep in mind, it is likely this is already looted and it is highly trafficked, but I found this to be way better than looting the Baloda airfield and staying at the Baloda airfield, shooting at each other with, I don't know, FNX 45 and M4 with little ammo. So I found this to be the better way, just ignoring the Baloda airfield, starting from Kamenka, running right up to those loot spots, because it's those loot spots are all the way up to the northwest airfield, and there's so much loot on the entire way. So much loot. So in the making of this video, I actually experienced a server restart. Right now I don't find any loot, because this is quite close to the coast still, and this server has been up for quite some while. So, finding any loot here was rather... I would have been surprised more if there was loot than not finding any loot. Because it was... this area was up so long. So, anyway. We head up north and surpass Pavlovo into Selenogorsk, which also has a little military base featuring 2 barracks and 1 military hospital, or prison as we call them, because they have a little prison cell in them. Those prisons are able to spawn in medical loot like bandages, first aid kits and saline bags and all that stuff, and the barracks also have the chance to spawn a medical loot in the bathrooms. So yeah, I'm just taking a quick peek inside and showing you the barracks from outside. I'm not looting them right now. But I can tell you I didn't find much in those barracks. But only a couple minutes later the server restarted, and I actually found not only did I find a lot of loot, I also found a lot of players and I had to kill them. So yeah, I've changed a little stuff a little bit in my equipment right now. So I went up to Green Mountain. This is I don't know, you can maybe skip this. Green Mountain only has 1 prison, 1 military hospital. Even though they have a lot of loot, they have a lot of loot spawns and they are able to spawn in medical loot, it is only 1 prison right now. It's kinda disappointing. I wanted more from Green Mountain, and I'm positive Dean Rocket Hall and the entire crew, they will make more happening in Green Mountain in the future. I hope so. Maybe under underground base or something. That would be so amazing. So yeah, we head all the way up to Viber, and in the southeast of Viber there is a military base, which is this base is amazing. It has three barracks and one military hospital slash prison, spawning in medical and military loot all in once, which is pretty amazing. But you have to keep in mind this is also this is highly trafficked, so if you should always pay attention to what happens around here. I wouldn't take my loot for granted. So just quick peek on the barracks. And not looking inside right now. But there was some great loot in there. So, alright, after the military base in Viber, we head all the way up to the Northwest Airfield, to the south end of the Northwest Airfield, where one barrack and one prison slash military hospital is at, both featuring military and medical loot again. I'm being highly careful right now. As you can see, I am peeking around corners. I'm trying to stay in cover. I'm trying to scan the surroundings. Right now, I'm kind of relieved to see there's nobody in here yet, because the doors are still closed. And if the doors are still closed, that means nobody has yet looted them. It's kind of the main. Way to see if somebody has looted that. This door wouldn't open for me. As you can see right here, there is loot spawning in under the beds, so always make sure to look under the beds, because there could be so much loot in there that somebody just didn't see. So I'm taking a little swig from the water pond, from the water well. And I'm heading over to the medical hospital, military hospital slash prison. Also, again, scanning the surroundings, staying careful, because we have died so many times in the mod on the Northwest Airfield, and we know that it is fairly easy to just get callous. And if you're having that much equipment as I have right now, you kind of get attached to your life. So yeah, I'm going fast forward in the prison right now, because I'm staying so long, I'm looting so much. So I just thought maybe fast forward that stuff real quick. Also, be very, very careful that nobody locks in the prison when server hopping or anything. I should be really careful, because that happened to me in Kamenka. That's not in Kamenka, in Zelenogorsk, in the prison, that happened to me. That was kinda, thank God I had my pistol out. I gave him some quick headshots and it was done. So this is ill advised. I would not advise you to do this. Don't run across the airfield. I've scanned the airfield carefully. That's why I made a little cut. But I ran across the airfield because I didn't want to go all the way around. So I'm not looting all the hangars or the big halls. Like this one, there are 9 halls on the entire airfield, all spawning in loot, all having the chance to spawn weapon scopes. So if you search for scopes, make sure to loot them, but I would not advise you to loot them if you don't have any people with you, giving you backup, giving you cover, because it's really, really open. And with the Mosin and the long range scope, it is quite easy to get you sniped if you don't pay any attention. With a 800 meter zeroing on the Mosin sniper rifle, on the Mosin hunt, Mosin hunting rifle, I think is the name. What 800 meters zeroing? That is the best long range weapon there is in the game just yet. So the game right now is kind of glitching out, kind of giving me a little desync. Wouldn't let me pick up that, so I'm doing the wiggles. Apparently that didn't help. I'm trying to pick up the keys, but he doesn't. The game is gonna disconnect in just a second, but it doesn't matter, because it reconnects real quick afterwards. So again, this is ill-advised. I would not advise you to do this at all. I would not advise you to do this. I would not advise you to loot the fire station on the northwest airfield, because it's not worth it. It's not worth it. If you don't have any cover, do not loot it, and for Christ's sake, do not climb up this. Do not climb up. I just wanted to show you this stuff spawning on top of the fire station. There's almost always an FNX and an FNX magazine or a holster. So if you search for a weapon in Cherno, make sure to climb up on the fire station. So as I climbed down this ladder, I stood right up. I stood up using the C button. Make sure to always do that before you do a leap of faith from the fire station down. It's because if you don't do that, it could be he's taking a sprint and then dives downstairs. He doesn't usually like that. So yeah, the ATC, the ACT, the air control tower, also spawns in loot, spawns in some weapon attachments. But this is really open. I would be really careful when looting this, and I don't know. I don't think it's worth it. I think looting the barracks, the prisons, is more worth it. I would not recommend looting this if you are not sure nobody's here. So I'm running across the airfield, giving me a little fast forward here. So yeah, the entire airfield has 3 barracks, 4 prisons, 1 ACT, 1 fire station, and 9 hangars, and another military campsite, which we will see in just a second. So I'm not sure if somebody's in there, because the doors are already open, but the cell door is not. And there's stuff inside. I was kind of surprised. This door is also open, but barely looted. So I'm kind of... Right now I'm in the mentality of I don't want to loot anything anymore. I just want to rush through the airfield, because I'm kind of loaded, and I just have to sort out all the stuff in my inventory. But as you can see, there's a lot of stuff spawning in. Always the M4s, nobody's picking them up anymore, because all the people that come up here already have M4s, because the loot route is amazing. It's really easy to find them. So I'm picking up the ballistic helmet here, even though I liked my radar cap a little bit better. Safer sex, am I right? So get out of here and make our way up to the next barracks. So yeah, the northwest airfield is really, really loaded, but as you can see, I'm really careful right now. I'm walking with the cover, I'm working all the way around the barrack, I'm looking, I'm scanning. So always make sure to do that, always make sure to save yourself. And I'm sitting in here. All doors are open, I'm kinda worried. Somebody must have been here already, but I could not... I didn't understand where he went. Maybe he surpassed me, maybe I ran all the way around and he ran across the airfield to the buildings that I looted already. Maybe he just surpassed me. So I'm just looking from the outside if I can see him inside. Nobody's in there though, as far as I can see. I'm not interested in the stuff that's inside there. I'm just running. Maybe I can find the person I was kind of thinking. Maybe if he headed northwards, if that is a word, maybe he headed towards the north, I could maybe catch him. But I didn't find him. Spoiler alert. But yeah, so we're running up to the north. There's another prison. The door's open again. I'm kind of worried. I'm sitting in the brush looking at the door. But as you can see right now, I'm looking through the window. I see the medikit. I'm like, who the hell is not picking up that medikit? Did somebody loot this already? I don't trust you. So yeah, I'm walking up using the third person advantage. I can't wait for first person service, as this is really unfair. And I'm sorry for using it, so. If you're a first person player. So there's so much loot in here. Food, water, hatchets, backpacks, weapons, ammo, everything you could imagine. There's also a first aid kit and a bandage on the ground. Holy F, dude. So yeah, that's a bandage on the ground. As you can see, I'm hungry, but I'm too worried to stop to eat. Like, I'm really paranoid right now. It's like 3 a.m. in the morning. I just want to get done with the video. I don't want to die on the last few steps. So I'm fast forwarding again, running around, scanning the surroundings, and there's the northwest airfield campsite, which is new to the game. I'm standing here looking at it. I'm going fast forward for the entire thing. There are 11 lootable tents. Only the tents that do not have any wooden floor, only the ones that have grass ground are lootable, and they spawn in a lot of stuff. They spawn in a lot of attachments and tuna, ammo. Like, they are really, really good with ammo. I like it. I really like what they did. I can't wait for all the tents to be lootable, because the ones with the wooden floor do not spawn loot in just yet. And but I like the idea how this is built, and I really want to have a gunfight in here, a firefight in the tent side, because there's so much cover. Like, if you look at it, so much common adds, there are these sandbags all around. It's really cool here. I like it. So, looting the last few. And I find a M68 optic scope, broken, but doesn't matter because I find, I think, one tent later. Ooh, two tents later. No, three tents later. Crap. Do I ever find this? Well, at least I find another red dot scope, which is not broken. And also, if you're wondering why I'm picking up the same sized, same looking magazines, that's because you can actually reload from those using the reload button. Instead of just switching the magazine, you can actually reload into that magazine, which is pretty cool. So yeah, I'm taking the... Am I taking it? Yeah, I'm taking the vest with me because it's because it's camo. And it's always good to have camo. So those are also lootable. They can spawn and loot on top and on the ground level. For this one I'm just looting the ground level. But I find the RDS optics, the red dot scope optics, and I'm checking out how much zeroing it has. And it has 400 zeroing. The red dot scope is amazing. So I'm running up into Bashnia, into Bashnia. I don't even know how to pronounce that. So I'm just clearing the zombies real quick. I see the main gate is still closed. I'm not worried he went up into the north, but that is again ill advised. Just kill them with your axe if you're here. Just safer sex. So I hear zombie, where is he? Coming around the corner. I don't hit for shit. So opening these doors right now is really, really complicated. Alright, so there's one military hospital slash prison in Bash, and also a well if you're thirsty. Nobody ever loots this, I feel. I have not seen this looted once. Maybe people don't know about it, I don't know. But it has been good for me. It has been spawning a lot of loot that I need it. So I'm picking up the alcohol to treat my wounds with, if I ever had one wound. As you can see, there's a lot of medical loot spawning in, the alcohol, the first aid kits, some M4s, and all that stuff. It's nice, I like it. I'm taking out my pistol, maybe someone is spawning in. I'm really, really lucky with the 60 round magazines. I know I find 3 in the entire loot, in the entire loot route. But yeah, one more 60 round magazine, so much ammo, and all that stuff in here. So I'm just running out again. Or am I finding something? What am I doing? Oh, okay. Looking what that is. So, I'm going out again, and that is the end, guys. If you enjoyed it, make sure to like, favorite, subscribe, and share it with your friends. And also, make sure to always pay attention where you're going. Alright, guys. Goodbye.